right. Let's start attaching some rockets.
For our first test, we're going to attach 10 rockets, 5 on each side. That should give us equal balanced propulsion. The critical factor here is simultaneous ignition of all the rocket motors.
Now we wire.
Attention to detail is critical as we wire every connection precisely and hope that each of these igniters goes off at the same time.
I am curious to see if all 10 rockets fire simultaneously, and if they do, will it track straight? That's the behavior I'm gonna be looking at for this test.
The test course for our junior Jandrum trial run, just like the beaches at Normandy, we have our strip of sand, obstacles of barbed wire, steel spikes called Czech hedgehogs, and finally, the impregnable seawall, in this case, made out of cardboard boxes, and of course, tiny heroic soldiers.
That looks beautiful.
It does.
All these leads are hooked up to our battery that will fire up our rocket motors and send our mini Panjandrum on its way. We hope.
We are hot. You ready to go?
We're ready to go.
All right. Here's hoping for 10 rockets all at once. In 3, 2, 1. Oh, it smells like the 4th of July.
It does, all that black powder.
Oh, look, it's burned a track.
Yeah, it's all sticky.
Yeah, we literally were burning rubber.
Yeah.
That test yielded some genuine information.
Looking at the high-speed camera footage, we can clearly see that we didn't quite achieve our goal of simultaneous ignition. That rocket right there lagged behind by a fraction of a second, causing our junior Jandrum to veer to the right. Also, it seems that the nearly 75 pounds of combined thrust produced by our 10 rocket motors was a bit too much power for our 7-pound Panjandrum.
I'm kind of inclined to try it at like 60%, like 3 rockets on each side.
We're going to take it down a notch and try to dial in this thrust-to-weight ratio.
3, 2, 1!
Whoa! And it's doing a pirouette. Let's see if it sticks the landing. Oh, the Russian judge is gonna give it a big score for that. Well done, everybody.